Welcome kids! Magandang buhay sa inyong lahat! This is your mom, Shiny, and welcome back to our mathematics class in grade 4 for our third quarter. So, for our new lesson, we will discuss about describing triangles and quadrilaterals. As you can see here, below, there are triangles and quadrilaterals. So now that we are in a pandemic, do you see inside your house some triangles and quadrilaterals? Like these images below? Okay, so for our lesson, we will describe those. So please stay tuned and watch this instructional video for you to learn more about our lesson for this week. So our objectives is to describe the attributes or properties of triangles and quadrilaterals using objects or models, and relate triangles to quadrilaterals. Let's have a review. I am the common endpoint of an angle. What is this? You're right. It's called the vertex. Second, I am an angle whose measure is 90 degrees. The answer is right angle. You're right. Third, I have an angle whose measure is less than 90 degrees. This is an acute angle. Number four, I am an angle whose measure is more than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. It is an obtuse angle. Very good, kids! Now, look around your house. What shapes can you see? So remember, class, everything around us has shape. Man's creativity enables him to create useful objects of different shapes and can even shape the things created by God. So look around inside your house. What shapes can you see? Let's take this situation. The math class of Mr. Raposas drew two kinds of polygons. Two girls showed their drawings. Yoleta drew a three-sided polygon, while Lolita had a four-sided polygon. So where is the three-sided polygon, kids? And where is the four-sided? Okay, we have this, the triangle, which is a three-sided polygon. And we have here the four-sided polygon, which is a square. So, let us discuss first what is a polygon. So, a polygon is a closed figure made up of several line segments that are joined together. The line segments are called sides. Here are the line segments. The line segments are called sides and do not cross each other. There are exactly two sides that meet at a point. So as you can see here, that's the point where these two sides meet. And here another point, and here. So what do we call a three-sided polygon, class? It is what we call a triangle. Very good. So as you can see, class, we have here this point and this one and here. And these are the line segments, which we call the sides. So there are three sides. And as you can see, the the meaning of tri is three. That's why this polygon with three sides is what we call triangle. So remember, any three-sided polygon is considered a triangle. Okay, class? Now, the next one, we have four-sided polygon. So, with the word quadrilateral, wherein the quad means four, quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon, wherein there are four sides that is included here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there are other kinds or other forms of triangle and quadrilateral that later on you will see in our example. So again, triangle is a three-sided polygon and quadrilateral is a four-sided polygon. And a polygon is a closed figure made up of several line segments or sides. Now, so triangles also classified according to sides and angles, which we will discuss in our next lesson. And quadrilaterals have their classifications too. If you divide a quadrilateral diagonally, you will form two triangles. And how will you do that? Let us see. Let's take this as our situation. Mr. Tabilang bought a cartolina for his math class. He needs two triangles of the same size without wasting any part of the cartolina. How will he divide it? So as you can see, this is the whole part of the cartolina. This one. So, he will divide it into two triangles. So, all he got to do is to cut this part until here. From here to here. And there you go. Mr. Tabilang will have two triangles already. So, what shapes are formed after he divided? Okay, very good. Two triangles. So as you can see, class, in a quadrilateral, you can form two triangles. Or you can form triangles. It depends on how many parts will you divide the quadrilateral. And if ever you will divide it again into four, you will get four triangles. So again, let us remember that a polygon is a closed figure made up of several line segments that are joined together. And a three-sided polygon with three sides and three angles is what we call a triangle. Triangle, three sides, and three angles. And a quadrilateral is a polygon with four sides and four angles. Now, can you tell whether each figure is a triangle or quadrilateral? Number one, what is that? Triangle or quadrilateral? Number two, what's this? Triangle or quadrilateral? Number three, triangle or quadrilateral? Number four, number five, and number six. Okay, class? Do you have your answer for this? Okay, for number one, it's a triangle. Number two, four side means quadrilateral. Again, for number three, we have four sides again, which means it's still a quadrilateral. Number four, can you count the sides? We have one, two, three, four, which means it's still a quadrilateral. How about for number five? Number five has three sides, so it means it is a triangle. And for number six, it has four sides, which means it's a quadrilateral. Very good. That's great, kids. Now you know about polygons, wherein we have triangles and quadrilaterals. And when you divide a certain quadrilateral, you may form or have triangles. So, class, what is a triangle? A triangle is a plane figure with three sides and three angles. Always remember. And what are quadrilaterals? A quadrilateral is a plane figure with four sides and four angles. So here in the picture, how many triangles are there? How many quadrilaterals? So you apply your skills. Have this as your written work. Draw a rectangular garden at the center. Draw a triangular pool. Again, draw a rectangular garden wherein at the center of that garden, you have to draw a triangular pool. Design your garden with any four-sided objects that will make it beautiful. Okay, kids? Okay. For your assessment, draw a triangle if the object mentioned represents a triangle. And draw a quadrilateral if it does not represent a triangle. Number one, Abe is reading a book. Ayan is using a tripod in doing his experiment. Number three, Amado is opening the door. Gani is standing near the traffic sign that says Children's Crossing. And number 5, Raphael is writing on the chalkboard. So answer these in your paper or in your notebook. Very good, kids. So that's all for our lesson about describing triangles and quadrilaterals. So thank you so much for watching this video. And again, this is your mom, Shimi. See you again in our next class for Mathematics 4. Mabuhay tayong lahat, sulong edukalidad. Thank you, kids. Bye.